Welcome back. Cervical cancer claims the lives of 11 Filipino women every day. And in celebration of National Women's Month, we put a spotlight on this disease to help raise awareness on how to prevent it. We are joined by Jack Ruiz, spokesperson of Women Workers for Health Empowerment Network, and Donna Miranda, project officer of GPAIGO. Donna, Jack, thank you so much for joining us here in Top Story to talk about this.
Thank you for having us.
Now, let's start first, Donna. I mean, for some of our viewers who are not aware of cervical cancer, can you tell us more about it and, you know, how it's caused by the HPV virus?
Yeah, okay. I'll start off by saying that GPAIGO supports the Department of Health. Actually, we're giving technical assistance to strengthen awareness for cervical cancer, but also to improve the coverage, prevention coverage among Filipino women. Cervical cancer is caused by the virus, human papilloma virus, or HPV, which is transmitted through sexual relations. All women age 30 to 65 should be undergoing cervical cancer screening every 3 to 5 years. That is to say that all women who has a cervix or who has a uterus is at risk for cervical cancer, because HPV virus can be transmitted through sexual relations. And when we say sexual relations, we don't mean just penetrative sex, but all kinds of physical contact or skin-to-skin contact that is involved during a sexual activity.
And what are some of the risk factors, of course, for cervical cancer?
Well, the number one risk factor for cervical cancer is not getting screened. As I mentioned, basta may uterus ka, at risk ka. So the only way you will find out if you are at risk for cervical cancer is to undergo screening every 3 to 5 years, either through pap smear, which is the most common, or visual inspection through acetic acid, and the new technology that the Department of Health is introducing, which is called HPV DNA testing, which provides the option for self-collection. Ibig sabihin, yung babae, hindi niya na kailangan mag-undergo ng speculum examination para malaman kung meron siyang at-risk siya for cervical cancer.
And I mean, Jack, we just reported a while ago that, you know, cervical cancer claims 11 lives of Filipino women daily. So obviously, there is a lack of awareness there, lack of protection and coverage. And how does your organization help to address this?
Yes. The network actually focuses on the women workers. While women are the most vulnerable sector in our society, but we still eat that the women workers are the primary beneficiaries of this screening, because we see that the barriers, like the access to health, is one. Most of the workers do not include in their budget to get screened or to get to the hospital when they are sick. Second is that the wages is too low to access more to the facilities when they get. I believe it's like 5,000 to 8,000 getting a test for cervical cancer screening. And thirdly is the information, I guess. So practically we have like the local clinics in our barangays, but dissemination, local information is not really available for those in the workplaces. So the initiatives, actually, we go into communities, we go into to the workplaces to get the women workers screened. And it's a women-to-women approach. So it is more of like getting to know and really appreciate that women are the ones that they can turn into whenever they had this, whenever we have this cervical cancer screening. So parang ang effort is that ilapit sa mga workplaces o sa mga komunidad kung saan nandun yung mga kababaihan. At the same time, lahat ng kababaihang sa komunidad ay makilahok at matransfer yung aming ginagawang mga serbisyo at training, kasi hindi lang actually siya serbisyo yung suporta ng GPAIGO sa aming network, kung hindi yung itrain din sila, kasi hindi naman kami forever nandoon sa mga workplaces at komunidad. So maganda rin na itatransfer yung knowledge para magtuloy-tuloy yung awareness raising and capacity building ng mga kababaihan ito.
And aside from the fact that is a women-to-women approach, you know, how does this also solve, I guess, you know, hesitations when it comes to privacy and confidentiality, you know, of course, cervical cancer screening?
Actually, dun sa mga nilunsad namin, hindi, walang awkwardness. Parang dahil nga women to women itong approach na ito, mas relax, mas makakapagkwento, no, yung mga kababaihan. Unlike na pupunta ka nga naman, since ito nga ay self-collection, mas parang komportable yung mga kababaihan na itest yung sarili nila. And at the end of the screening, they like parang debriefing, meron parang debriefing how you felt, so ganito pala ito, so simple lang pala. Kaya parang yung transfer din na ang approach ay makakikayat ka pa ng ibang mga kababaihang manggagawa para magpa-screen din.
And Donna, with this kind of advocacy, I mean, how can eliminating cervical cancer in the workplace not only help, you know, the employees, the environment, but also the community?
So women make up 50% of the productive force of the country. So imagine if all women, as I mentioned, are at risk for cervical cancer, imagine the economic repercussions of not having half of the workforce. Yeah. Or at least 10% of half of the workforce affected with HPV, high-risk HPV. So we see this as not just strengthening the health of women, or the Department of Health actually sees this as maintaining the health of the whole country, because they are important contributors to economic development. And the cost of treatment of cervical cancer when somebody has already has cervical cancer is almost $1 million at a minimum. Yeah. Imagine how much the government will have to put up, spend if this is $1 million, compared to having prevention methods in the workplace, in the community, in partnership with civil society, but also private sector, to be able to ensure access and link women to these accesses.
And what other initiatives and programs do you have in store for women who are undergoing cervical cancer, for some who are too scared to test for themselves? What other offerings are there?
Tuloy-tuloy po yung aming community and workplace visitation. We engage in the local government unit to partner with us din. Actually, marami na pong communities, local government unit na nakipartner sa amin years ago. And then ito po, nagtutuloy-tuloy siya dahil nakita po namin talaga na yung importante. And they welcome us because meron po silang katuwang to initiate yung information dissemination and awareness raising po. Lalo-lalo sa mga workplaces na talagang limited din naman talaga yung access sa ng mga kababaihan. So, as we see it, magdedire-diretso po yung aming services and aming information drive and campaign to end cervical cancer.
And go ahead. Donna.
Yeah, kasama doon, syempre yung isang malaking barrier but ayaw magpa-screen ng mga kababaihan, lalo na yung may hirap. Ayokong malaman na may cancer ako. Yeah. Dahil ayokong magbukas ng isang pintuan na hindi ko kayang harapin. So yung mga kababaihan katulad ni na Jack, ng mga grupo ng mga manggagawang kababaihan, kasama sila sa pag-navigate ng patient through the services until the end point, until if a woman is found to have cancer, then they will be assisted to navigate the system, to access diagnostics, to be linked with our partner, to be linked with partner implementing institutions and cancer centers, so to be linked with the Department of Health Cancer Centers all throughout the process. Because when a woman knows what to anticipate, then mas maganda yung parang, sige na nga, magpapascreen na ako kasi alam ko na yung maaasahan ko.
And when we talk about, of course, cancer, it's not just the person undergoing through it, it's also their friends and family. So we've discussed how you've offered and you will be offering support to those women, but how about to their family and friends, because they too, you know, also need that support from their own circle, you know?
Yes. Mahalaga yung patient navigation, yung linking them to support services. Because as a cancer survivor myself, or having had someone who had cancer, the caregivers are always worried every minute of their lives because they don't know where to seek these services. And networks such as WEN help link them to the support services, whether it is getting guarantee letters from PCSO, whether it is getting enrolled to the Malasakit program, whether it is getting enrolled to the PhilHealth point of care enrollment systems. Kasama yun doon sa buong package. At saka sa tingin ko yung pinaka-practical, yung may magagana lang ka ng ulo
mo. A shoulder to lean on.
A shoulder to lean on.
That's so important. And how can people, of course, you know, avail of this? How can they message you guys for questions or to actually be part of this movement?
Yes, we have a Facebook page. It's WEN, Women Workers for Health Empowerment. They can message us through our Facebook page or they can send us an email to wen@gmail.com. And yeah, maybe also with Japan.
They can link up with WEN and then to the Department of Health, as well as city health offices in their respective cities and barangays.
And maybe lastly, Donna, words of encouragement, you know, for women who are scared to get themselves tested or who are also, you know, experiencing those hardships from cervical cancer.
Yeah, cervical cancer is the easiest cancer to prevent and easiest to cure if detected early. There are only two cancers that you can prevent. That's liver cancer and cervical cancer. So sayang yung opportunity because you can only prevent cervical cancer if you get screened. So every time you screen, you increase your opportunity to be protected against cervical cancer. So, hindi dapat matakot kasi isa tong opportunity sa lahat ng umiiral na cancer dyan na maaaring maiwasan.
Jack Ruiz and Donna Miranda. Jack and Donna, thank you so much for sharing your story and your time here with us.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Salamat.